Hello everyone, welcome back. The topic for today is G.V. Black's classification of tooth preparation. Now this classification, it is the most commonly used classification for your tooth preparations, and this is a very commonly asked question in your VIVAs and also in your theory examination. So basically this G.V. Black classification, it comprised of 5 classes and later on class 6 was added. Starting with the first class, that is your class 1. Now this class 1, it is known as all pit and fissure preparation. So now over here, this is your molar typhoidont. These depressions are nothing but your pits and these lines are your fissures. So your class 1 is nothing but it is the pit and fissure preparation. Why? Because any preparation which is involving these pits or the fissures, they are nothing but your class 1s. First one is the occlusal surface of the premolars and the molars. Now this is your tooth. Now we know we have various surfaces. So over here, this one will be your occlusal surface. This one will be the lingual surface, buccal surface, mesial surface, distal surface, and the sixth surface is your gingival surface. So these are the 6 surfaces of your tooth. So in this class 1, it says that the preparation that you're doing on the occlusal surface of the premolars and the molars, that means they are your posterior teeth. So the preparation that you're doing on your occlusal surface of the posterior teeth, it comes in the class 1. Like over here, so this is your molar tooth. In this, the preparation that you're doing on the occlusal surface is your class 1. Over here, this is your premolar. So the preparation that you're doing on the premolar's occlusal surface, that is your class 1. Now the next thing, it says that the occlusal two-thirds of the facial and the lingual surfaces of the molar. Now over here you can see, so your tooth, it is basically divided into like 3 parts. So the first one will be the near the occlusal surface, the second will be your middle third, and the last one will be your gingival third. So gingival third is basically the one which is near the gingival surface. So instead of considering this as a middle one, you can consider this as the occlusal two-third. And this one is your gingival one-third. So the second statement, it states that the class 1 is the one which is having the preparation done on the occlusal two-third of the facial and the lingual surfaces of the molar. Now over here, this is your molar tooth. So when the preparation, it is extended on the facial or the lingual surface over here. So for example, now if you have the carious lesion which is present like this, which is involving the buccal aspect or the facial aspect. Now you are going to do the preparation as such that you're going to do the preparation on the occlusal surface and you're going to extend it in the buccal or the facial surface. That is nothing but your class 1 compound. So it is nothing but a class 1 preparation. And the third thing, it says that the preparation which is done on the lingual surfaces of the maxillary incisors. So when you're doing the preparation on the lingual surface of the incisor is nothing but your class 1. So over here, this is the occlusal surface preparation that you have done on the molar and the premolar. Over here now, this is the preparation which is done on the facial or the lingual aspect of the molar. Now it can be as such, it is involving only the occlusal third, or it can be over here in the middle surface. But now if, for example, if the caries is present over here in the gingival third, so that means it is not a class 1. That will go into the class 5 classification. So you have to remember this point very well. Till here, till occlusal two-third, it is class 1. But when it goes in the gingival, it will be your class 5. So over here now we have seen about the occlusal two-third of the facial and the lingual surface. Now over here, this is your occlusal surface, and over here, for example, this is your facial surface. So when the carious lesion, it was present such that you're doing the preparation on this facial aspect, that means it comes under your class 1 compound. So this is nothing but a class 1 compound. Now this is your conventional class 1, that is first, like the first point that we have read, that is the occlusal surface of the premolars and the molars. So this is the occlusal surface, the preparation that you are doing on the occlusal surface of the molar, and this one will be your premolar. And there's one more thing that you need to remember for this class 1 is the class 1 conservative tooth preparation. So now what do you mean by this? So in this, basically it is when you are preserving or you are conserving the ridge. So now moving towards the class 2 of the JVS Black classification. Class 2 is nothing but it is the proximal surface of the posterior teeth. Now over here we have seen when, so these are the 6 surfaces. For example, these are your 6 surfaces. So occlusal surface, then the facial surface, then the lingual surface. All these 3 surfaces, it comes into class 1. Now what about mesial and distal? So when the caries is involving this proximal surface, that is your mesial or the distal surface, so that will come in your class 2 preparation. So these are nothing but the proximal surfaces of the posterior teeth. So in this only premolars and molars are involved. So over here now you can see, so the preparation that you're doing on both the surface, that is your mod preparation, that is mesial, occlusal and distal. So now over here you can see, so you have done the preparation on the mesial aspect, you have done the preparation on the occlusal aspect, and even you have done the preparation on the distal aspect. So that is nothing but your class 2. Now in this, this is a premolar. So for example, you have done the preparation on the mesial aspect. So that is nothing but your MO, that is the mesial and the occlusal surface preparation that you have done. Now over here, this is the plaster model. Now you can see over here, this is for example your mesial surface. So in this, you are doing the preparation occlusally also, and mainly it is the proximal surface. So if for example this proximal surface is intact and there is no carious lesion, so this one will be your class 1. But now if your proximal surface is involved, so that is nothing but your class 2 preparation. So now this one is the mod tooth preparation. Now over here, if this is your mesial surface, if this is your distal surface, so over here now both the surfaces are involved, but they are proximal surfaces. So it will come into the class 2 preparation, tooth preparation. So this is your MOD preparation. So this is for your molars. And for this over here now, in this also, now we have seen about the conservative in class 1. Same will apply over here in class 2 also. Now moving on towards the class 3. So class 3, it states that it is the preparation which is done on the proximal surfaces of the anterior teeth that do not involve the incisal angle. Now for example, this is your maxillary incisor. So this is your incisal angle, this is your incisal angle, and this is your incisal edge. So class 3 states that whenever you're doing the preparation on the proximal surface, and that means it is not involving this angle, so that is nothing but your class 3. So over here now you can see, I have done the preparation on the proximal surface of my incisor, but now in this the incisal angle is not involved, so that is nothing but your class 3, as over here you can see. So over here, so this is the proximal surface of your incisors, but it is not involving the incisal angle. Now in class 4, it states that the preparation is done on the proximal surface only, but in this the incisal edge or the incisal angle is involved. So that is nothing but your class 4. Now over here, as you can see, the incisal edge is involved. So that is nothing but your class 4. Now for example, if I am doing the preparation and it is involving my incisal edge, so that will be my class 4. Moving on towards the class 5. So class 5, it states that the preparation which is done on the gingival third of the facial or the lingual surfaces of all teeth, that is your class 5. Now you have to remember about this in class 1 and class 5. So in class 1, we have seen that when the preparation is done on the occlusal two-third, whereas in class 5, it is the gingival third. So doing the preparation on the facial or the lingual surface. So now over here, this is your premolar. Now over here you can see, so you have done the preparation in the gingival third, that is your class 5. And later on this class 6 was added, that means the preparation which are done on the incisal edge of the anterior teeth or the occlusal cusp of the posterior teeth. So if you are doing the preparation over here on the cusp only, or if in the incisors, if you are doing the preparation over here at the incisal edge only, so that is nothing but your class 6. So that was all about it. I hope you found this video helpful, and if you did, then please like, comment, share and do subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much.